Friends, I am Vijay Kumar S. Biradar, Assistant Professor in Electrical Engineering Department and Head General Science and Engineering Department at N.B. Nawale Sengad College of Engineering, Solapur, with 19 years of experience. Today we are going to discuss the subject Control System 2, and in that the topic Introduction to Design of Pole Placement. So one drawback of the frequency domain design method is that after designing the location of dominant second order pair of poles, we keep our finger crossed, hoping that the higher order poles do not affect the second order approximations. We've seen in our frequency domain design that the design is approximated towards the second order pair of poles. We call those pair of poles as the dominant closed loop poles because they are dominated over the remaining poles for the system performance. Therefore, by considering that dominant pair of second order poles, we are designing the controller in frequency domain design. Frequency domain method of design do not allow us to specify all the poles of the system of order higher than 2. Even though the system is of higher order, we are approximated towards the system of second order system. One gain to adjust or compensator pole and zero to select does not yield a sufficient number of parameters to place all the closed loop poles at the desired locations. The meaning is that by adjustment of only gain or the compensator pole and zero, it is not sufficient to place all the closed loop poles at the desired location. Remember, to place n unknown quantities, you need n adjustable parameters. So the state space method solves this problem by introducing into the system other adjustable parameters and the technique for finding these parameter values. On the other hand, the state space method do not allow the specifications of closed loop zero location, which frequency domain methods do allow through the pole placement or the placement of the lead compensator zero. So here we are not going to place any kind of zeros, only we are placing the poles of the system. Finally, there is a wide range of computational support for state space methods. Many software packages support the matrix algebra required by the design process. However, as mentioned before, the advantage of computer support are balanced by the loss of graphic insight into the design problem that the frequency domain design or frequency domain method yields. So here we don't have any graphical insight of the design process or the design of the control systems. In this lecture, we'll discuss a design method commonly called as a pole placement or the pole assignment technique. We assume that all state variables are measurable and are available for feedback. If the system considered is completely state controllable, then poles of the closed loop system may be placed at any desired location by means of state feedback through an appropriate state feedback gain matrix. Means, if the system is state controllable, then we know that these states are controlled by the feedback or that control input U. So we are going to adjust the value of U with another gain matrix K, and that is utilized for relocating the existing poles of the system. The present design technique begins with the determination of desired closed loop poles based on the transient response and or frequency response requirements such as speed, damping ratio or bandwidth, as well as steady state requirements. By choosing an appropriate gain matrix for state feedback, it is possible to force the system to have closed loop poles at the desired locations, provided that the original system is completely state controllable. If the system is completely state controllable, then and then only it is possible to locate the states or to locate the poles of the system at the desired locations. So consider a plant represented by the state space as x dot is equal to ax plus bu and y is equal to cx. This is the block diagram for the block diagram representation of the plant. In a typical feedback control system, the output Y is fed back to the summing junction. That means the feedback is considered to be the output, and that is fed back at the input side, and it is compared with the reference input. Okay, that is the general case. And it is now that the topology of design changes. Instead of feeding back Y, we feed back all the state variables. So we are not going to feed back the output Y, but we are going to feed back all the state variables. If each state variable is fed back to the control U through a gain Ki, there would be n gains as Ki that could be adjusted to yield the required closed loop pole values. That means with the help of this Ki, we are going to change the value of U, and that is used for relocating the closed loop poles of the system. So the feedback through the gains Ki is represented in the following figure by a feedback vector K. So here it represents X through this negative feedback K. It is represented at the input U. Therefore, this U is equal to R minus Kx. And the representation of the system X dot is equal to Ax plus Bu becomes Ax plus B into R minus Kx, which will simplify it and will obtain that X dot is equal to A minus Bk into X plus B into R. And the equation of Y, it is Cx only. We will limit our discussion to a single input, single output system. That means we will assume that the control signal U and output signal Y to be a scalar zone. We will also assume that the reference input R of t is equal to 0. Therefore, here that R of t becomes 0. Therefore, this U is equal to minus K into X. Right? Therefore, X dot is equal to A minus Bk into X plus Br. It becomes X dot is equal to A minus Bk into X, where U is equal to minus Kx. Now, this U, this control input U, is totally dependent upon the gain matrix K and the state variable X. Therefore, X dot is equal to A minus Bk into X. The stability of the transient response characteristics are determined by the eigenvalues of matrix A minus Bk. In the system that we discussed previously, the location or the response is obtained by the matrix A. Now that matrix A is replaced by the matrix A minus Bk. Now this A minus Bk represents the matrix which is responsible for the modified or the response which is modified by the gain matrix K. If matrix K is chosen properly, eigenvalues of the system can be placed at the desired locations. So by changing the value of K, we can place all the eigenvalues, and these eigenvalues are nothing but the poles of the closed loop system. Therefore, we can relocate the poles of the closed loop system at the desired locations. And the problem of placing the regulator poles or the closed loop poles at the desired location is called as pole placement problem. Therefore, we can place the poles of the system at the desired locations with the help of this state feedback gain matrix K. This K is known as the state feedback gain matrix because we are going to relocate all the states of the system with the help of this gain matrix K, and the determinant of this A minus Bk represents the system poles, and with the help of this K, we can adjust the location of the closed loop poles and we can get the desired performance from the given system. Thank you.